Hello students, today is Tuesday, 17th of September 2019. Yesterday, a very important story came from Jammu and Kashmir, wherein former Chief Minister, or rather three-time Chief Minister, and presently the member of the Lok Sabha, Farooq Abdullah, was arrested. And he was arrested under an act which is known as Jammu and Kashmir Public Safety Act 1977. Now, let us understand what this act is about. This is an act which was brought by Sheikh Abdullah, who was the father of Farooq Abdullah, in 1977 when he was the Chief Minister of Jammu and Kashmir, to prevent smuggling activities, particularly the smuggling of timber. So, this act was brought with a very clear-cut objective, but in later years, there was a lot of misuse happened of this act, wherein political prisoners were continued to be arrested by the government. And till date, this act is used in a big way, wherein political leaders in Kashmir, certainly not the mainstream leaders, but the leaders who are involved in terrorism activities or supporting terrorism, or who are called the separatist leader like the Hurriyat leaders, they all are arrested under this Jammu and Kashmir Public Safety Act. But let us understand what are the other laws which are there in India which are considered draconian or which are considered very repressive laws. In India, the constitution was implemented in 1950, and interestingly, the same year an act was passed by parliament which is called Preventive Detention Act. This preventive detention is a very, very old thing in India, despite all kind of freedoms which have been guaranteed in Indian constitution. Now, this very first act of 1950, this was challenged in the Supreme Court in the case Gopalan versus State of Madras, but Supreme Court upheld this Preventive Detention Act with certain conditions. In 1967, there was another act passed by Parliament, which we know as Unlawful Activities Prevention Act. And you would have noticed this, that very recently an amendment was brought by Parliament in this act, wherein an individual has also been included, wherein if somebody is involved in terrorism activities, etc. There used to be few acts which came and which went away after a few years, like we can refer to MISA, that is Maintenance of Internal Security Act, which was brought by Indira Gandhi government in 1971, and it was scrapped by Janata Party government in 1977. Another act which was brought in by the Indira Gandhi government was the Coffee Posa. It was brought in 1974, that is Conservation of Foreign Exchange and Prevention of Smuggling Activities. That is how this Coffee Posa, this was also scrapped by Janata Party government. When Indira Gandhi government came back to power in 1980, it got another act passed by Parliament, which we know as National Security Act, NSA. And now, what are the regular laws beyond these special laws? Now, all this is covered in Criminal Procedure Code 1973. So, one very common section of this CRPC, which we all know, is Section 144, wherein there is a provision that if there are more than 4 persons assembling on any public place, that cannot happen once this section has been imposed. And this is obviously for maintenance and keeping the law and order. There is another section of this CRPC, which is 151, under which anybody can be arrested. So, lot of detentions and arrests happen under this 151, and even the house arrest is also an extension of this. Now, if we refer to Indian constitution, there is one article 22 which is a shield for a citizen to prevent arrest, but in that article only there is a provision wherein the state can arrest somebody on reasonable grounds. So, that is there it itself. There is another article in Indian Constitution which we know as Article 32, which is a right to constitutional remedies. This means if anybody's fundamental rights are being violated, that person can approach to the Supreme Court or any of the High Court for the protection of those fundamental rights. This is covered under Article 32, and then the protection or the action of the High Court is covered under Article 226. Under this, you can file a writ petition. There are several writ petitions mentioned in the Constitution, but one interesting writ petition is a habeas corpus. If the court, Supreme Court or High Court accept the habeas corpus, this means the court will order the law enforcement agencies, the police, to produce that person in person before the court. In Farooq Abdullah's case, Vaiko, who is an MDMK leader from Tamil Nadu and also a member of the Rajya Sabha, he filed a case in the Supreme Court, filed the habeas corpus, and the matter was listed yesterday. And if the court would have accepted the petition, then the Supreme Court would have ordered the production of Farooq Abdullah in Supreme Court physically. So obviously the government did not want that, and before the Supreme Court could take up the case yesterday, so before that the administration in Jammu and Kashmir imposed Jammu Kashmir Public Safety Act on Farooq Abdullah. And what is this Public Safety Act? That a person can be put in the detention, either to the jail or in the house detention, if public order is threatened. And for public order, the detention is for 3 months to 1 year. But there is another provision in this, wherein if there is a threat to the security of the state, then the detention is possible from 6 months to 2 years. When this Pulwama happened on 14th of February, and on 5th of August, this when this section 370 was scrapped, between this period, there used to be at least 150 habeas corpus petitions in the Srinagar bench of Jammu and Kashmir High Court, out of which the court has disposed of 39 petitions, and in 80% such cases where the court has given the verdict, the detention has been found illegal and the court has ordered for the release. And since the time, since 5th of August, when this 370 was scrapped, since that time about 4,000 arrests have been made in Kashmir, out of which 300 arrests have been made under Public Safety Act. And out of these 300 people, almost 10-12 people have approached the Supreme Court against their detention through the habeas corpus writ petition. So that is all in today's edition.